What is up, guys? Back here with the about to play the Falcons and become 5-0. Hopefully, you know, looking at the Falcons' record, they're 2-2. The two games that they did really well. Their defense is really good. So let's see.
Hello again, everybody. It is the coach. You're tuned in to Madden 19 on EA Sports.
Play moment. We're gonna run it, guys.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Is James White. Space to maneuver at the 40. And a fast footwork by White. And now off to the races. Down the right side.
Let's go.
And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. James White, his third touchdown. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them. They're gonna have trouble if they can.
Trying to remember what it was. Steal? Is it steal or dive?
Throwing in too much double coverage.
I think it is steal or dive. No, it's not steal or dive. I forget what it was. We're gonna go to James. Or I might do Cook.
Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Safety Keanu Neal there to knock that one free.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise.
Verticals, curls, big return, blinker drive, four verticals, corner strike, fade out, smash drive, four vertical sealers drive. I'm gonna do levels.
Now they face a third and 10 after back to back incompletions.
Let's go now.
Now Roethlisberger to throw. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first, thanks to
loving
a
it.
Little spin move. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. Big Ben, not the most agile quarterback in NFL history, but he can use those legs when he needs to.
He really can, and I think it starts with him taking contact and shedding people trying to get him on the ground. That's when he becomes the most elusive.
Yeah, something he honed back at the University of Miami in Ohio.
Yeah, and they didn't get him down in the MAC. It's hard to get him down in the NFL.
Eluding the pressure right. That's caught inside the 20. And he's going to take it in.
Let's go.
Touchdown. Julian Edelman, his ninth touchdown of the season.
Play type. Guys, what is the play? We'll play that again.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
Let's go. Completions, guys.
Two first quarter touchdowns. The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter.
Going to the ball now.
Burger on first down.
He's going deep for Brown. That's caught inside the 20. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown.
Guys, what a game. Let's do some run plays again. Edelman, Cook, White, Brown. What's next?
The drive starts with a run by White. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Now second and seven from the 23. On second down, here's Roethlisberger.
I was getting trampled in there.
Incomplete. He was looking for his big tight end there, Jesse James. And it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just jump away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. There's Roethlisberger.
I got leveled up again.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
Steelers cross, this is it. Yep, this is it.
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you gotta try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. Escaping the pressure.
Let's go for some.
Eventually taken down, but how about that athletic spin move we saw? Gives him the first down yardage. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth.
Not sure I agreed with the decision to go for it, but I definitely
I want to go Amendola.
Decision to run it. He picked up that big first down. I think he let his head coach off the hook.
That's what I was just going to say. If there's anybody more happy than the quarterback, it's caught inside the 25. And into the end zone.
Let's go, guys. What a game. You want to run it?
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. They'll start the drive with a give to White. And they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that would look like it might be
35-10, guys.
Any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
There we are.
Here's a former 1,000-yard rusher, Stephen Ridley.
Come on. Why is Ridley winning?
About the 38. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Well, no matter how they phrase it,
everybody but Crabtree has a touchdown.
The sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger. He sets to fire deep. It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler.
We're going to stay in now. And we're going to play some defense. This game is so high lead, guys.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan.
Use his sack. Sack him, boys. Run ball back.
Jolt, one of the few things that's gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory.
I'm just going to mess around, guys. Do some draws here. Guys, no, this is me messing around. This is not me being good. Because I've never done a play like this. See?
Losing 3 yards here, and that'll make this a second and 13. They'll run with White, and he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
See if I can make this, guys. I could have made that. They're trying to hold me, guys.
He's going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now the Steelers use the first of their three.
No, I'll kick it. I'll kick it.
Stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. On fourth down, here comes a Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick.
Guys, I'm literally killing them right now.
Fielded at the 34. Powering his way forward.
How?
21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Falcons are set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already.
Yeah.
Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. It's a loss of four. Now third down. Well, they try to swing it out.
Guys, I suck at defense. That's why really nice. I always do offense.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the...
I didn't even time it. I didn't even press at that time, guys.
As it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now.
Miss it. Oh.
Bryant's kick is good.
There's no way they're going to come back. Return.
So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And he is out of bounds up past the 10. Final play of the first half, barring a penalty, as they come up on first and 10. On the toss, here's White. And he's going to be taken down.
I try, guys.
That will lead us to the end of the first half of play. You want the third quarter already?
Job.
Down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47.
third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team.
They go play action with Roethlisberger. Flushed out right. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Scrambling not particularly a Roethlisberger strong suit, but he does get the job done there and gets a first.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Play action, it's Roethlisberger sliding out of the pocket. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. And it's second down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Back up just a little bit. Let him go. Catch it.
Complete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. The Steeler first down on the pickup.
Who they gonna give me? They're not gonna give me Ridley, are they? On any given oh my God, this guy can't run.
Exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Oh.
It's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Edelman runs the intended target. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second.
Amendola. Amendola, let's go.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down.
Let's go.
Amendola. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 20. Back now in Pittsburgh. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four.
Go on, throw two.
Straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. Roethlisberger, he's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Come on.
Picked off at the 16, and he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a two-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here.
Oh,
indeed, try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw with this type of a game, I'm going to be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more. He's going to launch this thing way down. And that's caught inside the 30. And he's in. Touchdown.
Let's go.
Antonio Brown with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Ooh, a little cruel here. They're going to go for the onside kick up big. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it.
Let's do that so they can get closer.
They felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought
analytics
into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a...
I thought I got it for a second.
Number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time, you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical. You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play.
Let's go offense.
He looked like one of those guys.
And they'll get him down right around the 16. They only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. It's caught. Jones. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Now Ryan.
Wide open.
It's Sanu this time for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu.
They're gonna go for it.
Touchdown on the season.
Just not gonna come back.
Short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Only had a couple of yards to gain there on the 2-point conversion, and they were able to do it.
And how many teams shy away from running the football in a 2-point conversion? They treat 2 yards as if it were 20.
Bet.
If you're a good team running the ball, go to your strength. Go ahead and push it in.
I swear to God, if I get an interception.
That's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team.
Got a man that's caught inside the 10. And he's going to take it.
Let's go.
Steeler touchdown.
Amendola.
Touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to...
I missed it.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that's leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now. Because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. The risk reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play. And here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling. I mean, whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep.
Give me the warning.
Now they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back.
A great game.
We'll see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll lead here to a third down. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. From the gun on third down, Ryan. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton.
Let's go. Game over. I'm going to make another touchdown. I'm going to make it 60-35.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Now a carry for White, and maybe a measure of revenge there.
Let's go for a Hail Mary.
This one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge.
Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown.
Amendola again.
Danny Amendola, 40 yards. And the interception by the Steeler Dean leads to a touchdown. And with that touchdown pass, he has broken the record for the most in a single game. What an incredible day for this guy.
How did we get this lucky to be here to see this performance?
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit, but going for 2 in this situation... Somebody didn't like someone else. There is no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you... that's not a good decision. They didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think you can just say, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No.
Okay.
And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it.
What a game, guys.
On the NFL scoreboard, they've gone to the 4th in Cincinnati. And that one pretty well wrapped up. The Bengals growing the lead even further. If they hold on, a victory there would be their 3rd of the year. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
Good job, guys.
It looks like right at the 40. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and it's a 2nd down. From the gun, it's Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. From the gun on 3rd down, Ryan. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how
the game's been going.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It's way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
Miss it.
Yeah.
I can make a touchdown in 19 seconds.
Stay right where it is.
I tell you, it's not easy kicking field goals in the best of conditions. Yet in a downpour like we're in right now, it makes it that much harder, and sure enough, they can't convert here.
Now it's Roethlisberger going deep here for Edelman. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. He was looking for Edelman there. That'll bring up 2nd down. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all.
2 seconds left.
And they just took a timeout with 2 seconds to go. This one obviously decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. Roethlisberger gonna throw it. Flush to his right. Letting one go deep for the
end zone. Wow. I bet 61-35, I'll take it.
Incomplete. Well,
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast? A few highlights.
My favorite touchdown was the Hail Mary.
Just a big blob of green on the radar. They said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Get you laminated.
753 total the offense. Rushing yards, 220. 533 passing yards, 9 first downs, 21 first downs, 22 punt return yards, kick return yards, 1932, 447 total yards, 794 total yards, plus 1-1, 2 plus a negative 1. Guys, what a game. What a game. 4-5. And, oh, wow. Keeping Big Ben. Keeping Big Ben, guys. Upgrade available. There you go. Hope you guys enjoy, and if you guys do, please make sure to keep...